Happy Thanksgiving, fans. I'll put a link in the description for a GoFundMe page for the How to Prevent Dementia Foundation. Anyway, just wanted to make a video today, and I think this is episode 10 of the Banging on a Budget series. I'm going to go over here to my state-of-the-art tripod, which we'll be getting next week, and place my camera. And I just thought on Thanksgiving, what more apropos, that was nice, thing to do than to show you a plate of drumsticks. And that'll be my discussion today. Drumsticks. One of the more important elements of playing the drums, of course, is the actual tool that we use to bang said drums and said cymbals with. For years, I bought sticks strictly based on how they felt. I'd go to a place like Drums Unlimited in Chicago back in the 60s, or Frank's Drum Shop, and they used to, you know, open up each bag, a pair of sticks, and open up six or seven bags and throw them on the counter, and you could roll them back and forth and pick out any that were warped or whatever, and basically match your own sticks, which I thought was a pretty cool thing to do at the time. It was all about feel. You know, they had a rubber pad there, practice pad, and you do your, you do your closed roll and your buzz roll and a couple paradiddles, and if you could back stick a little bit, you know. 16-year-old kid playing for 2 years, they're trying to impress the guy that owns the drum store, you know. I'm sure he was just mesmerized by my skill. At any rate, spent the going rate for sticks all my life. One of the things I did notice was that places like Frank's and Drums Unlimited, they'd often have a bucket there with a bunch of sticks, you know, at like a third the price of other sticks. And sometimes they'd have their logo on them. And they, so they were inexpensive sticks that advertised for the drum store. But I found that I always liked those sticks. They're kind of like the size of a 2B, maybe a little bit shorter, but they were thick. I suspect because they were a lighter wood and the thickness would give them some durability, but they were thick and I liked that. Now I'm a big guy, I'm 6 foot and pushing 250, unfortunately. But I don't like 17, 18 inch long sticks. I like a 15, you know, 3/4 kind of stick, but I like them kind of beefy. But I like them kind of light. And that's what these sticks were. And they always felt marvelous to me. And I thought, why do these cheap sticks, you know, feel great to me? And I didn't come up with the answer for quite a few decades. I went like everybody else and spent a ton of money. And I went through series. I remember Ludwig had a laminated stick. You could see the layers in it. They had a Joe Morello that was a 7A, the Joe Morello style with the nylon tip. Man, I love that stick. And I'm not even a nylon tip guy, but anymore. I was then. But the main thing for me was, I didn't know where to get inexpensive sticks, and I just paid the going price, and it was all about feel. And it wasn't until I started, and I've always been interested in jazz, but it wasn't until I started playing jazz with some regularity 10 years ago that I thought, my God, the difference in sound on a ride cymbal, because all of a sudden I started looking for a ride cymbal sound. For you guys not familiar with jazz, I'm going to do this with maybe a pair of sticks that's not matched. The difference, a big difference between rock and roll and jazz is rock and roll is. It's all about the bass drum and the snare drum. Conversely, jazz is all about the ride cymbal and the hi-hat on 2 and 4. The left hand and the bass drum are strictly accompaniment, comping with some accents. So the sound of the stick on the cymbal is really important, and it's amazing how different it can be. It can be a very woody, pronounced sound, or woody, not so pronounced sound. It can be a very metallic, pronounced sound, or maybe less pronounced metallic sound. Or the stick can be so heavy that it's just a just washes everything out, which you definitely don't want, other than special cases with a jazz stick. Rock, different story. And my drum, it's hard to believe watching these videos that I actually had several instructors in my life, but my instructor most recently was Nick DiRico in Connecticut, and he was an endorser for Vic Firth, and he says, man, have you ever tried the Peter Erskine ride stick? And I said, no, I hadn't. And he had a pair, and I tried them, and man, they sound great on the cymbal. Nice woody stick sound. I'm not a metallic stick sound guy. I'm a woody stick sound guy. And I like that. And I liked that they were, I think, like a cross stick. Because, I mean, this is a pretty big stick. It's got a big diameter. I should know these specs. But it's got a big diameter, reasonable length, some beef to it. It's fairly heavy. So, I mean, you can play jazz all day long with it, but you can also play rock and roll with it. So it was really a good fit for me, and I played these for a number of years. Did think they were a little heavier than I liked. Again, you think, why do you want a light stick? Well, it's all, for me, it's all about the wrists and the hands and overcoming some of the deficiencies in my playing. I'm not as talented with fingering and placement of the stick and utilizing my hand. I see these guys doing all the stuff with their fingers. I don't do any of that crap. I should be doing it. I'm not knocking. That wasn't a knock. I mean, I just don't have that skill set right now. So I need something that I can manipulate, and a light stick feels good in my hands. But I forgot about those sticks of old that I used to get at Frank's Drum Shop and Drums Unlimited until I ordered, if those of you have been watching my videos, I did a review of a sound percussion drum kit, and it came with a set of sticks. Here is one of them, and that's all the description that's on it. I hope you can see that. Just says 5A, nothing else. And this, kind of beefy, very lightweight. That's the no-name stick from Sound Percussion. Even a little softer, woodier sound that I like and actually prefer to the ride stick, and I prefer the feel. So that brought my memory back. Yeah, I used to like sticks like this. So I started looking, and I went to Sound Percussion. I figured, well, Sound Percussion has some drumsticks. So I ordered some Sound Percussion drumsticks, and thinking, okay, I'll solve my problem right now. I'll just get some of those Sound Percussion drumsticks like I got with the kit that felt so great. And what I got was this, which has their logo on it, and does 5A, and is more varnished, which the other thing I like about some of these inexpensive sticks, they don't have a lot of varnish on them. You get a nice grip on them, they got a nice feel to them. And although this is a beautiful stick, and it's not warped, you can roll it on a granite surface, it's not going to wobble, and it was half the price, maybe less than half the price of like a Vic Firth stick, and I'm sure it's going to last a long time. It wasn't the same stick I got in that box. So that sent me looking all over the internet, most of it on eBay, and I found all these inexpensive sticks, some as low as $89.99 a pair. I didn't buy any of those. But, you can buy sticks for, $1.89, $1.99, three pair for six something. Freight prepaid from China, which I find amazing. Although it takes a while. If you order some sticks, some of these lower cost sticks, and it says China, understand it could take 4 to 6, 8 weeks for you to get your sticks. Find those sticks, but with an American distributor that says in stock, and you'll have them in 3 days. So what I did is I found some people like that, and I bought sticks for $2.50. I think that's what these are. These are Peng Yang, but they're straight. They got the right feel. So I'm pretty good on the drums, and I think they were $250 a pair. These might have been the ones that took a while to show up for me. Then a pair that's kind of becoming my go-to, at least for rock, and you'll see them there. Is this Riviera or Rivera? Rivera sticks, and you know, manufactured in Taiwan or China. Does it say? Doesn't say there. Oh, Rivera USA. I'm sure that made here, but that's what it says. But another clue here was, it says maple wood. So something that's highly desirable and more expensive in shells is maybe less so in sticks, where you would normally want hickory, I guess, and sometimes oak. So then I started looking and finding maple sticks, making sure that what I was getting was lightweight maple sticks. And I've been now saving a lot of money by buying sticks that are $250 a pair. And I like to buy, you know, I don't go through sticks like some of you young guys, but I like to buy, you know, a 12-pack of sticks. And at $10.49 for the Erskine, okay, you're in $120 or whatever. That takes a lot of the joy of playing out. But when you can spend $25 and get a dozen pair, that's a whole different animal. So I have been availing myself of the less expensive sticks for day in and day out. I did, though, once I realized that maple was the continuity of the sticks that I was looking for and finding desirable. I found that Vic Firth has an American Heritage maple stick. Nice lightweight. This is their 7A. Beautiful stick. And they have a 5A. In maple. That again has that beefiness and lighter weight. So I have a little schizophrenia. I'm buying the inexpensive sticks, but I'm keeping a few pair of the Vic Firth around, I guess, because in my mind I'm saying, well, if they're $10, and they must be better than the $2 stick. So when it comes, push comes to shove, I got a gig or something, I'm gonna use those. I don't know. But the bottom line is, banging for on a budget is all about how can we save money and not at the expense of quality. I'm never going to tout something that doesn't sound good, that doesn't give you some kind of durability and so forth. But I found all of these sticks work. One other thing before I sign off here, Talawans, the Steve Smith Talawan or Hot Rods or whatever we call them. I think they're like $18-$20 a pair. Jeez, that hurts, and I didn't need to do any rim shots or anything. You know, they start falling apart pretty quickly. I think these are an amazing price. I $3, $5, something like that. You know, again, look for multi-rod sticks or something on eBay. I forgot the exact thing. Maybe they're just under drumsticks, and you could get to, when you get to the price point, these will pop up. But oh my God, you know, they're fine. Drum don't know. The drum don't know if it's a $15 pair of sticks or a $2 pair of sticks. Anyway, that's my video for Thanksgiving. I thought it appropriate that I share a platter of drumsticks with you on Thanksgiving. I hope that you'll be eating some drumsticks pretty soon of the poultry variety. And I hope that you all have a really wonderful Thanksgiving and have a lot to be thankful for, and you know, hopefully no sad or tragic things going on in your lives at this moment in time. And I thank you for your support, and I'm glad you stopped in to view my video. I'm trying to build a community, so please like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye-bye.